This time we're going to play the chip firing game a little differently. We start with no chips at all on the diagram. Since there's nothing we can do other than add a chip at the top, that's what we'll do. Now we ask ourselves, can any of these sites fire? That is, at any of these sites, does the number of chips equal or exceed the number of outgoing arrows? That's not true. So we have to do the only thing we can, which is add another chip at the top. But now we can fire this node because there are two outgoing arrows and two chips. So we send one chip along each outgoing arrow. Now there's nothing else that we can do. We can't fire this side or this side because each of them has only one chip, and we would need three chips in order to be able to fire along the three outgoing arrows. So we add another chip at the top. And then because there's nothing else we can do, we add another chip at the top. And now we can once again fire the node at the top. So we send a single chip along this arrow and a single chip along that arrow. But once again, there's nothing we can do because in order to fire this node or this node, we would need three chips and we only have two. So we add another chip there and then we add another chip there. And now we can once again fire this node at the top, sending a chip along each of the two outgoing arrows. Now we can fire these nodes because we have the requisite number of chips, namely three, to enable us to fire a single chip along each outgoing arrow from each node. So we're going to send a chip along each of these two arrows and a chip along this arrow. And from this node, we'll send a single chip along this arrow and a single chip along each of these two arrows. Now we're once again stuck. We cannot fire any nodes because at each of these nodes, we have four outgoing arrows, but only two chips. So to bring ourselves up to the requisite number of chips, we would have to repeat the whole procedure we've just carried out. So let's do that a little bit faster than we did before. Two chips, split them equally. Two chips, split them equally. And two chips, split them equally. Now we can once again fire these two nodes, sending one chip along each outgoing arrow. And from here, one chip along each outgoing arrow. Now these nodes are capable of being fired because they have four chips corresponding to the four outgoing arrows. So we send one chip along each outgoing arrow. And we wind up in a situation in which each of the four nodes at the bottom has exactly the same number of chips, namely three.